Heinz Doofenshmirtz is the infamous evil scientist of the tri-state area who has a long, complicated, and tragic backstory. I remember seeing all of the clips of his hard past, but I didn't understand how they all fit together, which is why today we are going to completely go through it all. Hello, I'm Isaac from What's Up Videos, where we discuss fun topics for fun people. On my channel, I focus on spreading magic by examining Disney films, so if you are new here, consider subscribing. But before we get into the origin of this ambitious genius, if you have big dreams like Dr. Doofenshmirtz, but desire more knowledge to help make that dream become a reality, consider checking out our sponsor for today, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with more than 25,000 diverse classes on skills like animation, entrepreneurship, film, web development, and much more. With the premium membership, training videos by industry experts can be viewed as many times as you need, allowing you to go at your own pace and absorb what you need. Today, though, Skillshare wants to help you explore your curiosity and creativity and push you towards learning what you need to make your dreams become real. So they are giving away 2 months of the premium subscription to the first 500 fun people who sign up through my link in the description. Join 7 million creators learning with Skillshare and support What's Up Videos by signing up today. The heartbreaking tale of Dr. Doofenshmirtz began all the way back at the time of his birth in Gimmelstube, Drusselstein, when his parents couldn't be bothered to show up. As he grew up, Doof became a peculiar boy who constantly smelled the pork, so for many years no one, not even his parents, wanted to be around him or interact with him. Heinz was an extremely intelligent boy, seen through him making his innator for a grade school science fair and an even bigger innator for the following year, but his cunning inventions and intellect were not appreciated as much as things like paper volcanoes. No one really seemed to be on Doof's side. When Heinz would go to his parents with his struggles for guidance, they would just say he was making a mountain out of a molehill. And he didn't just have few family or friends to be with, but he also was frequently bullied. Kids made fun of Doof's high voice, while Big Black Boots Boris kicked sand in his face at the most unexpected places, and a girl named Grilinda constantly dumped a bucket of water on Doofenshmirtz. The lack of friends and the bullying led Heinz to spend every birthday alone, but he did keep his spirits up by throwing himself surprise parties at places like Gunther Goat Cheese's, the goat cheesiest place in all of Drusselstein. Unfortunately though, his celebrations were fairly lonely and his Dunkelberry cake was often destroyed by the treacherous Dunkelberry bats. Birthdays wouldn't remain in Doofenshmirtz's life for long as most holidays were given up, but he never really had a reason to dislike Christmas. In addition to trying to create his own celebrations, Heinz would also make his childhood more bearable by being comforted by his giant cockroach named Hoarfrost and by eating garlic ice cream. Goodness, who would ever be comforted by something like that? These two things would not be in Doof's life for long though, which was made worse since the disgrace and neglect Heinz was given was only going to become more cruel. When brought to the high dive in Gimmelstube by his family, which was a rite of passage for a man to jump off of, Heinz couldn't bring himself to leap off due to so many onlookers laughing at him. Doof's father subsequently rejects him as his son completely, and both of his parents feel great shame in his presence. This is likely the reason Heinz's mother never let him swim in public pools when he was growing up, and what motivated his father to begin training a Spitzhausen, which he claimed was like the son he never had and was named Only Son. This dog will come into play later once the dog is fully grown. Eventually, due to Doofenshmirtz's embarrassments, his family disowns him, which forces him to live on his own for a while, and he was not a fan of this. While camping, Doof was attacked by bees, and although he was only stung by one, his fear of the woods became ingrained within him. Instead of camping during this time on his own, he allowed a family of ocelots to raise him instead, but he wouldn't be able to stay there. Needing money to keep himself alive, he got a job at a carnival as the ball that is thrown at the target at the dunk tank. And while he worked at the carnival to likely handle his loneliness, Doof got a balloon, drew a face on it, sprayed some lifelong lasting spray on it, which shows he was continuing to invent throughout his childhood, and named it Balloony. Even though Heinz had been forced to fend for himself for a long time and now had a friend of his own, when his parents fell into financial trouble, they forced him to return when his father's beloved lawn gnome was repossessed. While other children were allowed to relax and play games like Kick the Stupel, Doofenshmirtz was forced to be the family's lawn gnome all day and night, and was required to not move in the slightest for any reason, even to eat or sleep. He had to protect the Lassenfruit Gardens from witches' spells and wood trolls. At night, his only companions were the moon, his neighbor Kenny, and Balloony. Unfortunately, though, one night as Heinz protected the garden, Balloonie began to float away, and due to the demands of his father, he could not retrieve him. Doofenshmirtz had lost his first true friend. But while Doof worked to watch over his family because of the success of Only Son as a show dog, see, I told you he'd come back, Doof's father became wealthy and famous. Even though the Doofenshmirtz family was now fairly well off, Doof's father never used that money to get a new lawn gnome to free his true son from his burdens, which made Doofenshmirtz's self-esteem very fragile, and it would soon get worse. Doofenshmirtz's life is rough. When Heinz's parents prepared for their second child, who they believed was a girl, Doof's mother began to furiously knit a boatload of dresses for their new baby. The truth was, though, that their daughter was actually a son who they named Roger. So when Doof needed new clothes, but no material was left, they made Heinz wear the dresses, leading to him being ridiculed even more by the rest of the manly children at school. While Doofenshmirtz's parents clearly showed the resentment of their firstborn, it became even clearer as they poured their love towards Roger. Because of his amazing kickball abilities, Roger was praised by their parents since Doof's mother's love was inexplicably linked to kickball. Even though Doofenshmirtz had a cup-stacking world record, his failure to succeed at any sport involving kicking brought further shame upon him and led him to fail a jungle gym in grade school. Heinz did attempt to get his mother's affection by winning her a teddy bear with his entire allowance from a year, but when he gave this gift to his mother, she just gave it to Roger. Then in horror, Doof had to watch his bear be marked along with his mother by Roger's name, which effectively cut him out of the family dynamic, but Doofenshmirtz would not give up. He was determined to find something he could do to make people proud of him. Doof attempted to be a pretzel-making apprentice, but was deemed unworthy. Heinz tried magic, but he would frequently mistake Bobo the Rabbit for a skunk, and he also became intrigued by shadow puppetry in his teenage years, which allowed him to meet some Fräuleins. Not the first way I would have thought of doing it, but good for you, Heinz. Unfortunately, though, this fun with shadow puppetry became squelched when the girl he was interested in was stolen by Huge Hands Hans. This shattering of his hope of love was only made worse by his realization that he could not grow facial hair, which made him feel like less of a man. With Doof's inability to impress his family by his teenage years and with no solid ties to Gimmelstoop, Heinz's parents sent him to the store to get some Doofenkraut, but when he entered, he soon realized it was a trap to send him to America. Once on American soil, after a long, laborious sail, Doofenshmirtz didn't have much of a better life. In high school, he filmed himself during an embarrassing moment in his underwear and a cape while rollerblading, which eventually went viral online, making him a laughingstock. After high school was complete and the viral video was mostly over, he decided he would attempt to discover who he was through art, but struggled to find a muse. Heinz was able to find a reason to paint, and when he did so, he painted for 3 days straight and made a masterpiece, but his brother Roger, who had since come to America, spilled food all over the painting. Roger had ruined all of the momentum Doofenshmirtz had with his art, which infuriated the older brother, but he kept moving forward and decided he should pursue poetry instead. Unfortunately, Doof wouldn't gain much momentum with this artistic expression either, as he would lose competitions to baking soda volcanoes. After all these failures in the arts and with a need for money as a young man, Heinz decided to go into business for himself for the first time. Yeah, Doofenshmirtz the entrepreneur. Doofenshmirtz started his own bratwurst company named Doofenshmirtz's Quality Bratwurst. He may have had superior workmanship, finer meats, and exotic spices, which he was sure was going to make him successful, but the hot dog vendors were too much to take on, so he was unprofitable and was seen as lame. Possibly after this failure and with no real direction, Doofenshmirtz went and backpacked across Europe, which at some point caused him to no longer be welcomed in Albania. When he finally returned to America, he came back focused and was ready to fulfill his soon-to-be many-year-long passion. With the realization he could use his gift to build innators to get back at all of those who had wronged him, Heinz enrolls into evil school to understand how he can take revenge. Now, this didn't last long, though, as many of his endeavors had, for in Evil 101, his teacher, Dr. Gavarlik, flunked him out of the school. He still took inspiration from evildoers like Dr. Lloyd Wexler as he moved forward, but wasn't ever going to get a formal degree. While all of these problems in school were occurring, Doofenshmirtz was also getting into the dating scene more seriously. At one point, he went on a date with Linda Flynn prior to her rise as a pop star, and she was actually the one who suggested that maybe Doofenshmirtz should start off small in his plots to rule the world and begin with something more reasonable to take over, like the tri-state area. That date did not go any further, but Heinz had now set his focus. Before he began his many plots to take over the tri-state area, though, he still felt he needed more education, so Doofenshmirtz attended a community college where he fell in love with Charlene. Doofenshmirtz never actually ended up finishing a degree, so he just decided to print a doctorate off instead and continued his life with Charlene. Now, Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz and Charlene quickly got married, and after that, they even had a daughter together on June 15th, 1992, named Vanessa. Doofenshmirtz loved his daughter and tried to give her the most special birthdays he could create for her, likely to make up for all of the terrible birthdays he had. While Vanessa was growing up, though, a rift between Heinz and Charlene due to a sock puppet named Mr. Tomato led them to become divorced, but they both retained custody of their daughter and were still civil to one another. Now with Dr. Doofenshmirtz's personal life finally stabilized, and with his goal of taking over the tri-state area solidified, he invests in a building for a great price, which he later found was because of horrible noise, begins building his many inators, and sets up Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated! Doofenshmirtz quickly gained credibility and soon became seen as a dangerous threat, so the OWCA assigned Perry the Platypus to stop his plans, meaning Dr. D had earned a nemesis and he was finally in the villain big leagues. Heinz Doofenshmirtz had a long and tragic backstory filled with neglectful, cruel, and sinister parents, horrible bullies, constant loneliness, and consistent rejection, but he rose out of all of that. Doof didn't allow his need for affirmation to stop him. When he moved from Drusselstein to America, Heinz kept pushing forward in his endeavors, found a passion, and became committed to it, allowing him to rise to become the clumsy, hilarious, and nefarious villain that we knew him to be at the beginning of Phineas and Ferb. But now I'd love to hear your thoughts. What do you think was the moment in Doofenshmirtz's backstory that set him up to become a villain? Let me know in the comments, along with any other ideas you have for future Phineas and Ferb videos. Also, thank you again to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Remember, they are letting me give 500 of you fun people 2 months of their premium service to let you explore your passions and learn new skills to help you become a better artist, business person, or whatever you'd like to be. So please take advantage of this by checking out the link in the description so you can not only help Watso videos, but also help accomplish your large dreams. If you'd like to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe and click that beautiful bell if you're new. And thank you to my wonderful Patreons over on Patreon who are amazing supporters of my videos. Finally, as always, thanks for watching and have a magical day.